on the cool side out today, so I thought tonight would be a great night to have buttermilk fried chicken legs. So this morning what I'm going to do is go ahead and put my chicken legs in to soak. I'll be using Tabasco sauce, buttermilk, onion powder, minced garlic, and of course the chicken legs, and I'm going to let it soak all day. So what I'm doing here is preparing my chicken legs, and I'm just using a little tenderizer here. And when you press down on it, you get all of these little needles that come out. And what that does is punches a bunch of holes into the meat and allows whatever you're marinating to get really deep into the meat. And it will help to flavor it, so you're not just having the seasoning and coating on the outside. So I'm just going to press down to the bone all the way around. And if you can see there, it just puts those little holes into the meat. And I'm doing this with all of the legs. This is a great thing to do on a chicken breast when you're doing a whole chicken as well. It allows the chicken breast to not be quite as dry. So I'm going to finish this last one up and then we'll get on to the marinating. So we're going to start here with 2 cups of buttermilk. I'm going to put in a good bit of garlic here. 1 teaspoon of onion powder, almost a full teaspoon here of Tabasco sauce. You can do that a little bit more in any of those seasonings as you prefer. I'm going to go ahead and give this a quick whisk, and then we'll get the chicken in. Now what I'm using here is just a 1 gallon Ziploc bag, and I've just put it into a bowl to sort of hold it in the upright position. So let's get the chicken pieces in there. We want to make sure that we're coating all those chicken pieces well. Massage it around a little bit, make sure all the chicken is well coated. Then I'm going to squeeze as much of the air out as possible. Seal it up. And we're going to get it into the refrigerator for anywhere between 6 to 8 hours. And I'm going to go ahead and leave this in this glass bowl, simply because in case it happens to leak or anything like that, I'm not getting any chicken juices in my refrigerator. See you tonight. My chicken legs have been soaking for about 8.5 hours in the buttermilk mixture. I'm getting ready to cook them here. What I'm going to be using today is pulling out the big guns. I'm using my 13-inch jumbo wok. You might want to wonder why. Well, the sides are deep enough that I'm hoping it's going to contain some of the splatter. Also, because it's concaved in where it slopes, I'm hoping to be able to get away with using a little less oil. It is flat bottom, so I do have some surface space down there to work with. So let's go ahead and get the chicken legs out of the refrigerator and get our mixture going. I'm going to start making my dry mixture. This will be the coating. I'm going to use 2 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of garlic salt, 1 teaspoon of onion powder. You can either use a half a teaspoon of cayenne pepper to 1/4 teaspoon, or 1/2 to 1/4 teaspoon of paprika. I'm going to use a paprika. Finally, 1/2 teaspoon of dry mustard. Go ahead and give this a whisk. Stir it up. Oh, you know what? I almost forgot. I wanted to add about 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. I've made the mistake before of making a really good chicken in a brine and then not seasoning the flour coating enough, and it ended up being a pretty dull tasting coating. So I like to make sure that my coating has a lot of flavor. So what we're doing now is we're just pulling the chicken out of the buttermilk, and we're just sort of dripping some of it off, letting it sort of drip back into the bag. It smells really good just from this. And then we're going to be shaking it up in our bag of dry mixture. Now, if you didn't want to use buttermilk, you could have also just brined this in some water and salt. That comes out pretty good too. And then we're going to shake this bag up. Make sure that all the chicken is coated. And then we're just laying it here on a wire rack to rest while we're finishing the rest. So I'll see you when these are all done. Chickens are all ready, and I'm just going to let them sit there. And here's the beauty of using a glove for handling that. All clean. All right, the thermometer is reading 350. And while this was heating up and the chicken was resting, I went ahead and gave the chicken another douse in the flour. Not in the liquid, but just in the dry. Sort of gives them that little bit of extra coating. You want to be really careful at this stage because your oil's hot. You're going to just put it in there carefully. So we're going to let this cook on this side for about 7 to 9 minutes, and then we're going to flip it over and cook it another 7 to 9 minutes. It's time to turn him. The nice thing about having this thermometer is that you can go ahead and keep watching the gauge. And it is a deep fry thermometer. You don't want to use a non-deep fry thermometer for that. We're going to go ahead and turn this around. You see it's got a nice crispy crust there. Probably could have left it a few more minutes. Ended up dipping down about 10 degrees total, so not too bad, but I was able to go ahead and turn up the heat a little bit to sort of compensate for it. We're going to go ahead and let the other side cook for about another 9 minutes or so. All right, we'll get this stuff going. There we have it. The fried chicken is all done, and I'm ready to give it a taste test. Oh, that's really good. The meat has flavor. The coating has great flavor. All in all, this was a very satisfactory run here with the chicken. And the wok worked out great. So I'm going to go ahead and serve myself up some green beans and a few sliced potatoes, and I'm having dinner.